This conference will now be recorded.
Everybody heard the voice? Video is recording?
Yes.
Okay,
yes, yes.
Perfect. I don't know, Friday also I have done, but it was not recorded. Again, I recorded. So it is problematic actually. Okay, fine. So what you can do is on Friday's session, you can go through it, try to do that POC, try to do that two flows. I will keep up to you only. Today I will discuss some query parameters. You are not able to do by tomorrow, then I will try to explain. Okay, so what is my intention is I want to make your hands dirty, then only you will learn, otherwise you will not learn. That is the only intention. Okay, okay, let me open the workspace. So most of the people are absent on Friday, so what I will try to do, just I will recap. So create flow, actually we have created completely. Okay, completely we have created create flow. Okay, and when we are hitting we are able to insert the record into database. So let me open this query, let me retest once again. Just I will give the input and I'll showcase. Okay, see, six records. As there is no primary key constraint on the table, so duplicate records also it is getting inserted, but is no that is no issue in real time. Actually the table creation and everything will be taken care by target system. We will not be caring about that. Our intention is only to insert the records, to create the records in the database. See, okay, for six records got created. Now what I'll try to do, for your sake I'll try to hit one more record so that you guys can able to see it. What I have done is like I have completed the flow. I made like I kept debug mode as well. Debug also I have kept. Debug helps us to see the data at each and every point. Okay, so that I have done. So just I will hit that and I will showcase it. Okay, I'm keeping as RAM and this fellow I'm keeping it as finance. Okay, department I can create as department. Just I'm giving the request. Okay, the request immediately, when you see in the last sessions when I have given the request, you could able to see the response immediately. It is displaying immediately on the screen. Okay, but here now it is not displaying. Why? Because our debugger is holding it. Click on S. So our debugger, that means the thread came to this point, and at this point what is the data we can observe. Okay, the attributes means, so this is as I said when we are discussing about FX, I told like there will be some input properties. Those input properties, all of them you could able to see over here. So the thing is like when MuleFlow has received the request, what all the things it is carrying, we can able to see it, we can able to observe. Sometimes we may get doubt what we have hitted, what that, which data is going, which data in the properties it is going, which data in the payload it is going. At that particular point, if you want to cross verify or cross check, you can keep the debugger and you can verify it. Here in this case, in the properties, these are all inbuilt properties. These inbuilt properties gives the information about the unique ID, code correlation ID, okay, URI params, URI query params. So all this information, which method you have used in the postman, we have used post, so that is the reason it is showcasing as post. I am hitting from localhost, so that is the reason 127 indicates that it is a localhost. So we could see that which this is the address from which it is hitting, right? And this is slash create is nothing but the path separator, the path separator which we have given in our listener. Even that also you could see. So what all the things it is coming, all that observation we can do. These are input properties. So in the flow we have not used any variables, so variables we are not seeing it. Payload, as of now you are not able to see any payload. Just it is saying application slash json. This application dot json, where we have setted it, we have setted in the listener. In the listener we have setted, right, hey, my input flow will take only json request. That we have already given, right, that already we have given. Where in the advanced properties, the in the advanced properties are media type, I guess it is media type, right? Media type only, na? Anybody has remembered? In media type. Let me go to the normal perspective. This is debug perspective. This is normal perspective. Let me go to the normal perspective. Let me click on listener and let me check. Let me check in the MIME type what I have given. I have given application slash JSON. That means I am saying like my flow will take only. My flow input will be JSON only. Even whatever the restriction we have kept it over here, that restriction also you could able to see in the payload. Hey, EDI is JSON. So our flow is saying, hey, whatever the input it is coming, it is JSON format only. It is indicating that. It is showing that. Okay. And in the transform message, what we have done in the transform message, we have, it is not yet transformed. Why? Because the thread came to that point and it just stopped. It is one of the certification question. They will give one flow. And at the transform activity, they will ask, what is the payload value? A. Transformed value it contains. B. Nothing. Only set payload it contains. C. Some both. D. None of the above. You have to say, why? Because the thread came here, but it does not executed yet. It has not executed yet. The payload is also, if you observe, payload is empty. Nothing is there. Only JSON parameter, media type, only media type, as we have said, set in the listener, only it is showing that. If you observe the payload, whatever the payload here I have given, even that also it is not appearing. Why? Because the thread has not completed the execution of that activity yet. Okay. So after clicking next processor, you can see the payload. That means after executing, after passing that element only, you can observe the payload. Okay. So if in the certification question, they will keep like this, they will give the dotted line over here. Now they will ask, what is the payload value? Then you can, what you can say is, whatever the input payload it is there, in the option, the input request payload, if the option is there like request payload, you have to select. Okay, they will confuse you. Why? Because thread is showing here. But normally people, what the people will think, if the thread is there, means whatever the data here we have, that data might be, it is coming. You people will be thinking in that way. That is wrong. The previous activity, whatever the previous activity executed, only it contains that data. Here I have kept logger. If you keep set payload, if I keep like hello, what people will think, what people will understand is, hello, input payload, C is like both, D is none of the above. Most of the people, what they will keep as the thread is here, instead of logger here, if I assume it is set payload, they will keep the answer as hello, which is wrong. Even the thread is there, the payload which is holding by the previous activity, that only it contains. It is one of the certification question. Definitely you will observe one damn question. This is damn.
So payload after the transform message will be the updated payload, right? Whatever.
Exactly.
Okay.
What I'm trying to say is like, instead of logger, if I have set payload, what people will think, in the set payload, whatever I have setted, now that value will be the payload. The people will think like that. That is wrong. Previous activity data only it contains. After executing this activity, then logger data will be contained here when the thread is here. Now when the thread is here, what data it contains in the logger, whatever the data is there, that is the latest payload. That's all. Not the data which is contained, which is executing by DB connector.
Okay, one more question. Okay. What's the correlation ID and how it gets populated?
Correlation ID is taken complete. It is a unique ID for every request. For every request, we should have. Think in Amazon, 100 crores of people are keeping the orders. Each and every order should have some unique ID, right? Instead of order number.
Yes. So Mule, like any point studio is generating it.
Yes, Mule is generating. Mule flows only will generate, not any point studio. This is only ID, right? The flow will create. Yeah. Okay. The flow will create. See, you have kept one order and you are trying to update that order. So for updating that order, there should be some unique ID, right? There should be some. Okay, let me keep the example in this way. two persons at the same time, they have placed the order. For example, you and me placed the order at the same time, 4-5 p.m. See, your order should get your response, my order should get my response, right? So if correlation ID is not there, means they cannot correlate the ordered ID. Okay, what makes at sense. The back end what happens is correlation ID. For your ID, there should be some unique transaction ID. If you are doing Google Pay or some transaction ID, it will generate. It is only unique for you, right? In the same way, correlation ID is unique transaction ID, I could say. In case of Google Pay, I'm saying transaction ID, but in case of Mule, I have to say correlation ID.
The order number, right? When you generate a place order number you have, but this correlation ID, it is specific to that particular transaction or?
Exactly.
Okay.
For that request only.
Request, we are not storing, right? It is a temporary.
No. Real time, what we will do, this correlation IDs also, see, as part of project execution, I have created three flows. Okay, this flow is calling another flow. That flow is calling another flow for calling target system. So in order to, there should be some unique ID that we have to transform. Hey, if the order reaches here, the correlation ID generated is by this. And again, from this flow only, another flow I am calling. Why? Because we cannot keep the heavy logic in one flow only, right? Think about the Java. Think about like SQL procedures. You cannot write the whole procedure in one procedure. You will be creating some reusable code, whatever you feel like reusable code. What you will do, you will create another sub procedure, right? You will create another procedure and you will try to call that procedure inside the main procedure. Am I right? Have you worked on that areas? Is it confusing?
No. Yeah, go ahead, please. So basically this is going to be this unique particular transaction ID, right?
Yeah, or let me tell you one. Let me tell you in detail. Let me tell like in procedures concept. See, procedure one is there, okay? So heavy logic is there. Example, heavy logic. The how much logic means so much code we have to write. So what, as a best developer, what you will try to think, first reusable codes, what you will try to create some sub procedures. Am I right? Sub procedure one. In this, you will be like keeping some reusable code. Okay, you will keep aside, and wherever it is required, wherever this flow is required, in the procedure one only, you will try to call sub procedure subproc one, and after writing some code. You have a requirement, right? This procedure you have to call. Okay, that means for completing one requirement, one task, you are taking the help of sub procedures as well for segregating the code. Am I right? And you will write some blah 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 and you will write. Am I right? So my correlation ID gets created over here, unique ID. This ID, when I am calling the sub procedure. Why? Because this procedure is a reusable code. This can be called by any other persons also, right? So what you will do, first when you are calling this procedure, you will try to send this unique ID to this fellow so that when the response is coming back, that ID only it will check now. It will verify. Right? Just you will inject, hey, the request belongs to this unique ID only. Whenever a response is you are trying to give back, try to take the help of this unique only for this unique ID only for that request. You are trying to say that in the Mule also the same concept plays. Here you are seeing only one flow inside flow also I can call. I will cover that concept.
So correlation ID is unique to each flow.
Yes,
correct. Okay,
each request, not flow, each request.
So within one Mule flow there can be different correlation IDs?
No, that is what I'm trying to say. See, different Mule flows will be there, but unique ID you will try to inject it. You'll try to inject.
It is for one transaction, basically.
Yes. See, you are clicking Amazon and just you are clicking checkout. See, you are doing only one click. After going to the coding level, so the person who is sitting in between Amazon and your warehouse system, they might be calling so many classes. If they are using Java, means they will be calling so many classes. If they are using any middleware, means so many flows they will be using it, right? So when you, for your transaction, that unique ID has to go till all the flows. You have to inject. Gopi, meeku ardhamaindandi?
Yeah, I understand, but
you got
only
it.
My
understand?
Yeah. My question is like, it is a pass-through system, right, MULE? So this whole relation ID we are storing somewhere, or it is a temporary?
We have to store in the object store. We will be storing it automatically. It will not go, only for first flow it gets created. For remaining flows, we have to inject the same ID into them.
Where in the database?
No, we have a concept like object store. Some people will follow database, but it is performance killing. So we will be storing in object store. First, for this request, we will store that into the object store. And when we are calling this flow now, that unique ID we will take from there, and the flow will move forward like that.
Okay, that is only specific to MULE, the object store.
MULE. Yeah. Object store, and those concepts are specific to MULE. In other technologies, they will use some other thing. They will keep in one as an activity. They will use in case of Java, like that.
Okay, but the correlation ID, how many days it will store in the MULE, or it is a kind of
time we have to set for 15 minutes. See, for each order should not take more than 15 minutes, right? If you are booking anything on Amazon, it directly displays within 15 minutes. You have to pay the payment within 7 minutes. It will show, right?
Okay.
It will show, huh? So the timings also, that 10 minutes or 15 minutes, whatever the business is expecting, that time we have to set.
Okay, once the request is processed, then the correlation ID is deleted after 15 minutes.
It will vanish. That also we only have to vanish. From the object store, we have to remove. And it should be ready for taking another request. Another request.
Okay. Got it. It is your a kind order of temporary value we are handling. Yeah.
Oh, so until the correlation ID expires, that TTL expires, it won't take another request. Right?
It will not take. If it is expired now, for that particular order, if something has happened, user has given some wrong data, something has happened, it is not responding. So what happens to that is immediately in the MULE logs, you will see a message like request ID got expired.
Okay, so for example, one user came and then hit that endpoint, right? Now correlation ID is generated, and for example, the TTL, the time for that is 10 minutes. So
until 10 minutes, it will till by 20 minutes, the whole process, your order has to complete.
Yeah. So, and that particular endpoint won't take any other order, like no request, other request will hit in that time.
It will hit that. What happens is like, definitely when it is synchronous, it will hold. It will hold until 10 minutes. It will not take another request. But think in a broader way. Think in a higher manner. Whenever the requests are processing, we will be using parallel execution. Okay?
Yeah.
So parallel execution. For your request, it goes. And for parallelly, we will be calling, na?
Yeah, okay.
So for other processes, if we have to keep parallel component. That means for each in MULE only, we have a concept like parallel processing will happen in for each. For each parallel is there. We will try to, in that for inside for that for loop, we will try to invoke the target system. So parallel execution will happen. At the back end, it will take care.
Okay.
But for your order, if you are, the response did not came at 10 minutes, means for your order only, it will say like it expired. Others it will process.
Okay, one more question here, like the parallel processing, right? There is a limit to how many process at a time it will run.
We have to mention on for each. We have to 100 requests at a time.
Okay.
10 requests or 5 requests.
Yeah, that is Okay, that is the one. And the early case, right? If it is failed, right? So the message will still store in Mule, or someone need to come and look at
it. In Mule logs, it will be there now. No. Okay. Definitely, mm-hmm. Your users will raise a P1. My order has not processed. This order has failed. Yeah. I have not put the success message. Please liquidate. Support team will look. That is what the job of support, na? We will support team.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you.
In any project, they meant for that only.
No, right? any project, but these are scenarios, right? We are talking.
Yes, scenarios, definitely. Yeah. In logs, we have to check and we have to intimate. See, your token got expired within the time limit. So you have given this wrong data. Whatever that analysis we have to give.
Okay,
I have executed this. Now you can say record inserted successfully, and we could see our record. Sixth, it has inserted. Okay, Sandesh, meeku ardhamainda matam Greek and Latin? How come ardham kaakapothe cheptanu
meeku ardhamainda?
Okay, very good. Navya, మీరు క్లాస్ అటెండ్ అవ్వలేదు కదా, కొంచెం ఒకసారి ప్రీవియస్ వీడియో చూడాల్సి వస్తుంది. ఓకే అంటే ఏం లేదు, ఇది కొంచెం హై లెవెల్ మాట్లాడుకుంటున్నాం. ఒకవేళ ఫెయిల్ అయితే, ఇప్పుడు 100 రిక్వెస్ట్ ఒకేసారి వచ్చినాయి అనుకోండి, ఒకటి ఫెయిల్ అయితే మిగతాయి కూడా ఆగిపోతాయా, ఆ టైప్ ఆఫ్ క్వశ్చన్స్ ఆగవు. ఏదైనా ప్యారల్ ఎగ్జిక్యూషన్ నడిచింది, ఏదైతే ఫెయిల్ అయిందో అది మాత్రమే. ఇప్పుడు అమెజాన్లో మీరు 100 పీపుల్ ఆర్డర్ ప్లేస్ చేస్తున్నారు, మీ ఆర్డర్ కోసం 100 పీపుల్ని మనం లైన్లో పెట్టలేం కదా, రైట్? మీ దాంట్లో ఎర్రర్ ఉంది, మీరు ఇచ్చిన డేటాలో తప్పు ఉంది. మీది ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అయ్యేంత వరకు మిగతా వాళ్ళు క్యూలో ఉండాలంటే కష్టం కదా, అమెజాన్ వాళ్ళు బిజినెస్సే చేయలేడు, అవునా? సో దానికి సినారియో ఏంటి, ఫర్ ఈచ్ యూస్ చేస్తాం. మీలో వచ్చేసి ఫర్ ఈచ్ పెట్టుకున్నాం అనుకోండి, ఎవరి ఆర్డర్స్ వాళ్ళకి ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవుతాయి, ఎవరి తప్పు ఆర్డర్లో ఎవరిది తప్పు ఉందో ఆ ఇన్ఫర్మేషన్ ఆ పర్టికులర్ ఆర్డర్ క్యాండిడేట్కి ఇస్తాం.
ఇక్కడ మనం లూప్ వాడలేదు కదా మేడం?
వాడలేదు ఇంకా, అక్కడ వరకు కాన్సెప్ట్ మనం మ్యూల్లో ఇంకా వెళ్ళలేదు. రియల్ టైంలో అది జరుగుతుంది, అలా జరుగుతుంది అని చెప్తున్నాను. గోపి గారికి డౌట్ వచ్చింది, అయితే ఇప్పుడు ఒక్కొక్కరికి ఒక్కొక్క ట్రాన్సాక్షన్ ఐడి వస్తుంది కదా, అది ఏమైపోతుంది అని
అడుగుతున్నాను.
అర్థమైంది కదా కాన్సెప్ట్, అర్థమైంది కదా? ఎస్, ఫైన్. నౌ so okay, fine. So what I have done, so this is what I have done in the Friday class. Okay, what I have done: update flow, delete flow, homework ichar. Try to do that. Okay, today also I am giving time, if not tomorrow also you can take. We will discuss another thing related to this only. I'm asking one thing. See, for insertion, actually we are doing the insert of record, that is fine, but I have a requirement. Now requirement enti ante, I need only this particular fellow's details, only Rajesh details only I need it. Okay, oka Rajesh details maatrame naaku kavali, I need only Rajesh detail. Then in that case what we have to do, naaku flow lo mule requirement, I have a mule requirement. Okay, insertion, creating of record you have done, that is fine, but I want only somebody has specifically asked, I need only Rajesh's details. What is his department, what is this, just we need those details, can you please pull it and can you send it? That is a requirement, that is a use case. Then in that case what you will do,
you either database select or query.
Yes, see, select query we have used. Yes, you are very near. Select query we have used, but what that select query has to do, that select query has to take only Rajesh details only, na?
Your employee ID, right? The ID.
With respect to ID, you need to pin. For example, yeah. See, here I need only Rajesh details. What I'll do, I will keep where class, I'll keep ID, I'll keep equals to, what is that ID?
Name and
3. So here I know, I'm seeing here and I'm keeping it. But postman does not know, na?
Yes.
Only that fellow's details will display. The same thing I need to get these details in the form of JSON through MULE. Okay.
Yeah, so you there, can query and pass the ID. Yeah, right.
You can query it, but from here, only this fellow's details only we have to send, right? Only Rajesh, only three detail, only employee ID detail only I need to send, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. So for doing that, what we have to do, that we will observe. So here, in this type of requirements, here will come the concept of query param. Query param. So the query param you might have heard, right? Just before I have seen in the debug mode, in that attributes only that query param is there. So we will try to use the internal property. Query param we will use, and we will use this concept and we will try to get the record. Use this property and get the record. We can do in two ways. One is query param. Another thing is URI param. So URI param also you can do it. URI param. By using this also you can do it. So first we will go for query param. Okay. Only if it is like selected people's data you need. If that is the requirement, you will be using these two. Now, some audit is happening. Third problem scenario. Audit is happening now. What they are saying is like what they are saying they want to get all the employees' details. Some audit is happening, so each and every person's what is the package, what is how he has drawn from last 5 years. That type of audit they want to do it. They need like all persons' records. Then in that case, what you will do, only you will use select query without any condition, right? The same thing here we have done. Initially we have done that only, right? Select query. Select query means all the person's details you are getting. So what the source system is expecting? Source system is expecting everything in the form of JSON. So in that case, how the flow looks like? The flow, in the flow, in the query, we will be writing only select query. Okay. So both this, all the three, we will be doing it now. Okay. For doing all the three, first let me start with select scenario. Okay. So what I'll try to do, I'll try to create one more flow, retrieve data, otherwise get data. Okay. I will create one flow and I'll keep its name as get data. Create one more flow. So this requirement now came on fly. We thought only create, update, delete, but suddenly the requirement increased. The business has demanded. Then what you have to do? You have to create the same. In the same project only, you will try to create one more flow. This flow is for getting data. Get data flow. Okay, name it as get data flow. Same thing, try to keep it as listener everywhere. Again, the same flow we are creating. Listener. Why? Because I want to hit from postman. So what you can do is get data listener. Okay, and here in the path you will be saying, okay, get data only you will use, or some other anything, any separator you can use, but in the real-time scenario they will be giving the path separators as well. You no need to worry, everything will be in the document. You have to understand and you have to follow. Okay, so in this case first I will try to get all the records, any records. This for this problem case first I am trying to solve it. I want to solve this one first. Okay, I'll try to keep for select query. Nothing is required now. No ID we need to send, right? So click on database. You will be getting select query. Try to keep it over here. Okay. Some name you just keep it. Retrieve record or something. Okay, configurations already database is there. Database details already here. We have already given that database connection. Select that. Okay, for this, try to write the query as select star from emp tester. What is the table name? Let me copy it. Okay. Yes. So you have written the record. So remember one thing, the output of database will be always like always it will be in Java. So I don't want that. See, whatever database output will be in Java result set, it returns. We should not use it. There is a powerful activity called transform. We know that. On Friday we have discussed transform activity, drag and drop transform activity. So actually while this while I'm explaining on transform on Friday, what happened is like that session did not got recorded. That is the reason I am repeating once again so that everybody can understand. Okay, so this transform is such a powerful activity. It converts from any format to other format. See, if it is in the form of Java, the target system is expecting in the form of Java, you can keep it as Java. If the target system is expecting as JSON, try to keep it as JSON. If the target system, source system, why? Because I have to return back, right? I have to return back this output to the caller. Caller means source system. Source system is expecting in the form of XML. Just after slash, you can change this format. So whatever the format, so this made Mule very easy. Why? Because this activity plays a very important role. It converts from any format to another format. From JSON to Java or XML to XML, what not to text. Hello?
Madam, session is not recorded, I think.
Oh. Hey, recording. Recording is in progress. It is recording. Yeah.
Okay.
So this part, the same thing I have explained on Friday as well, but it was not recorded. That is the reason again I am repeating. Okay, no worries. If you miss there, here you will understand that. Okay. So the same, now it is in the form of XML. If the source system is expecting, you can change only that format. Okay, in my current requirement, my requirement is like I am expecting in the form of JSON. So that is the reason I kept as JSON. So now see the output of database columns it is displaying here. So in the payload, this data we have. In the payload, it is displaying this data. So under payload, so at database, you have that you, after keeping your transform message, you could able to see the column names. These are nothing but column names of our table, ID, full name, department. So how intelligent this transform activity is, it can able to grasp that column names as well as part of payload. So that means here you are not modifying anything. Whatever the records you are getting from here, blindly you want to send those records to the caller. So for that, just under payload only this ID full form department is there na? So I'll try to keep payload only. Why? Because already it is getting the records for me under payload. So only if I make it as payload, this mapping will happen. That means whatever the data you are getting from database, same thing you are mapping it in the form of JSON. The meaning is that. Okay, now I want to check at each and every point. Let me stop the server. Why? Because you are not clear, right? Last week. So now I want to run. If you want to keep your debug breakpoint, just right click on that particular on any activity, you can keep that breakpoint wherever you want to stop that flow. Anywhere you can keep that breakpoint on any number of activities, you can keep. There is no harm. This is only for our purpose only. Okay, so when we are after deploying at each and every point, you want to check how the data is flowing. So any number of breakpoint here I kept, here also I can keep, no harm, nobody will stop you. Okay, if you keep at one place, I think it will be good. Anyhow, the flow will halt here. So keeping many also the same thing, it works in the same fashion, no difference. Okay, but on listener, if you try to keep, it will not allow you to keep the breakpoint. Why? Because on the listener itself, we are stopping, means the flow will not move. So that is the reason on source we cannot hold. We cannot keep the breakpoint on source. Another certification question. what they will do? Can we keep, it is a theoretical question, can we keep a breakpoint on the source of the mule? Definitely. See, today it is listener, tomorrow it can be DB, day after tomorrow it can be file, whatever it is, whatever the case is. On source activities we cannot keep the breakpoints. After source, in the whatever the activities we are keeping in process, on those, on those activities only we can able to keep the breakpoints. Certification question. Okay, so after keeping the breakpoints wherever you need, you can just run it in the debug mode, save it, it runs. Okay, sometimes for some people this allows for access, just allow it. In my system it is asking, so I am allowing. For some people it may not ask, directly it will start executing. Anybody is having any doubts? Multiple times it is asking, just I am allowing it, I am not doing anything, just I am allowing it. Okay, even though you have allowed, you are moving to debug mode, still it is in initializing only. Until you see the application as deployed, you should not hit from the postman. Okay, let it deploy completely. Meanwhile, what I'll try to do, it is now we have to change. For this, for select query, we don't want any, we need all the records. So we don't want any input to be sent, right? So here in this case, I am trying to get the records from the database. So what our method should be? In the insert, I am posting the data into database. I am keeping the data into database. So that is the reason I have used post method. But here in this case, do I need to use post? I am not posting, right? I am trying to get the data. So that is the reason you have to keep the method name as get. So separator also got changed. What is the, what separator I have kept? I think I kept like get data. Get data I have kept. Let me keep that only. No input is required for this. Only by hitting our mule URL, it has to get all the records in the form of JSON. That is the use case. Let me check whether it is deployed. Yes, it is deployed. Okay. Now, after seeing this message, go to your postman, try to hit it. Okay. Then it will come, the thread will come and stop it over here. The flow is not immediately showcasing the output because we kept a breakpoint in the flow. Try to observe it now. Okay, in the select record, nothing, no records are there. See, this is all, this is related to database only. What query we have used, it has given the information. So at this point, what is the payload value? If you see the payload, null. If you see the payload at select, null, it is not yet executed, so no data we could able to see. But at the select, on the select, what all the properties that are there for select, that you can see it. You have used the query, the same thing it is displaying. Configuration you have used. Yes, correlation will be created automatically. We know for each and every request it creates. Okay, so these are all like internally it is executing. Okay, so don't confuse this org mule extension. Why? Because all these are something like while writing a tool, while writing that connectors, they have used them. So that is the reason it is displaying. Don't get confused with that. Nothing we are going to do with all this stuff. Only whatever we know it, just will just try to observe that. In the select, only these things are there. Now in the payload, as of now it is null. Now after clicking the next processor, immediately you can see that payload has changed to 6. If I open it, there are 6 records. In the first record, if you observe, 2 is there, full name Kiran, finance. And in the first record, it is like 3rd, full name Rajesh is there. So yes, Raju. So how many records are there? Those many records, it is given by database. If you see, abstract map is there, hash map you are seeing. So each and every record, if you are opening, if I open this again, it is key value pairs. Key is this, value is this. So each and it is storing. That is the reason I said the output of database will be, the output of database connector will be always in the form of Java. Nobody will understand that. If I send the same data without converting into JSON, they will not understand anything. That is the reason in the transform activity, we have converted into JSON, which is expected by source system. Now I'm executing transform. Now you could able to see on the transform, see, you can see all the records. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All the records you can able to see it. Whatever is there, all those are we are getting. Okay. Is it clear?
Yes.
Is it clear? Yes. Now I will try to enhance. Yes, please.
Hello.
Yes, please.
Yeah, yes, here. So we are putting the breakpoint, we are getting the results. So suppose if we are not put the data breakpoints, so where can we find the that logger? What is the data we are getting from the source?
See, if you remove this now, nothing will hold, right? Directly you can see. Let me, that is what we have done in our initial classes, right? I have not kept the logger. See, I feel like logger is not required, so I have not kept. If you want logger, you can keep it. Logger will not harm anything. Na logger emi cheyadu, adi console lo display chestadante. Meer ekkada pedtaro akkada payload em untado ade display avutundi. Logger has no logic. We are keeping logger only for our sake on the console, in order to display on the console ante. Console lo okasari data ela vastundo manaki chuddam anukunnappudu pettukuntam. Anywhere you can keep in process tab, anywhere you can keep, after any activity you can keep, no harm in that. Okay, meri breaker teesesar ankonde, meer ikkada breakpoint pettakunda normal ga right click kotti run chesi chudandi, em avutundi meeku, ekkada hold avu, flow will not get hold directly, it immediately within seconds of time. See, I kept a debugger, so that is the reason it has taken 2 minutes 35 seconds to execute that flow. If I am not keeping that breakpoint, na, within 0.05 seconds it will display directly this response.
Yes.
Okay. Now let me modify this. Now another requirement I have, I want to use query param. First anybody the query param, first this all chesamo, that is fine. What I'll try to do, I need specific record. We can modify in the same flow, or we can take separate flow. Okay, so what I'll try to do, I don't want to confuse you, I don't want to mess up your brains, so I'm taking separate flow for this. I'm taking separate flow, get specific record flow. Get specific record. Okay, naku specific record matrame kavali, deeniki oka listener pettesandi http. As we are in initial classes, so in the existing flows I am not modifying. Later once you become comfort na, then I'll try to modify in the same flows. Get record I am using. Okay, that is fine. Same select query only we have to use, but we have to select query, select, select statement, DB statement, select only we have to use. So here my database is there. So I have no issues. I'm dragging and dropping here. Okay. What I'll try to do. So first here, when you are using query parameter, what is query parameter? First we need to understand. Let me take another thing. Here also I'm getting the record. So that is the reason I have taken the get method. Here, question mark, EMP ID, EMP ID is equals to 3. I want to get. So this question mark indicates that we are using query parameter. So for everything, there will be a syntax, right? There will be a syntax. Pratidaniki oka syntax untadi. Question mark, if we use question mark, that indicates we are using query parameter. The same thing we can get, but if I am using like slash, that indicates it is here in URI param we use slash. This is the difference. If we are using question mark, it is query param. If we are using slash, that is URI param. So as of now, I am not going for URI param. I want to discuss on query param only. So let us discuss on this. So here EMP ID I am giving. So how this value will we have to inject in our DB query? That we have to think. Okay. So after question mark, whatever the column names are there, all those comes as query parameters. Okay. Now what I'll try to do, first let me use the same database connection. Why? Because the same database we are using. Let me use the same query as well, but we have to use where class. That's fine, we will be using it, no problem. Same where class only we will be using. Whatever we are using in the SQL developer, the same thing we will try to use it. Okay, but instead of 3, see, today I want to test with the 3 fellow. Tomorrow I want to get 5th record. Later on, I want to get first record. Later on, I want to get some other whatever I require. Runtime parameter I want. Dynamically, whatever the value I am sending, that record I have to get. Then what you have to do? You cannot keep that static value as 3 over here, right? We cannot keep it. That is not the right thing. So we have to use something else, right? So for getting dynamically, what you can try to do is colon, keep some ID like that. Temporarily you keep like this. Okay, so through now I have to make use of query param. This is nothing but a property under attributes. So what we can do is we can use ID I am giving. What I can use enable in the input parameters. Input parameter is there here. So that means whatever the after colon, whatever you are declaring, try to declare that value here in the MULE expression language. So what you can do is keep braces, try to use in the single quotations, try to use it as ID. After ID, try to keep it as colon. And now I need to get from the postman, I am giving as employee ID. So this value has to sync with this ID. What I have to do, click like attributes. Attributes, we know it. It is nothing but the properties of MuleFlow. Attributes dot. Automatically, these properties will come. Try to use query param. See, here, there is a query param. Try to click on that. Try to click query param. It comes query params dot. Whatever the value you are giving in the any point, in the postman, try to copy this. Try to keep it over here. So that means dynamically you are tracking that value through attributes parameters and you are assigning that value to ID. Does anyone has any questions? Are you able to understand? We are binding it. So whatever we are using in the where class lo edaithe use chesamo, దానికి మనం వాల్యూ పంపించాలి కదా. మ్యూల్ అట్రిబ్యూట్స్ ప్రాపర్టీ ద్వారా, క్వెరీ ప్యారం ద్వారా నేను ఎంప్లాయీ ఐడి ఏదైతే పోస్ట్ మ్యాన్లో ఇచ్చానో ఆ వాల్యూని ముందు తెచ్చుకొని ఇది యూస్ చేయడం వల్ల ఆ వాల్యూ వచ్చింది. అంటే ఇక్కడ ఇది యూస్ చేయడం వల్ల ఇక్కడ 3 ఉంది కదా 2 వాల్యూ అనేది ఇక్కడికి వస్తుంది 2 అనేది వస్తుంది అప్పుడు ఏమైంది ఐడి ఐడి కోలన్ 2 అంటే ఏంటి దాని అర్థం ఐడి వాల్యూ 2 ఆ 2 తీసుకెళ్ళి అది ఇక్కడ పెట్టుకుంటుంది ఈ క్వెరీ ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అయిపోయింది గాట్ ఇట్ ఎవ్రీవన్
మార్చుకోవడానిక మేడం డైరెక్ట్ గా మార్చుకోవడానిక ఈ క్వరీ
మార్చుకోవడానికి కాదు నాకు ఓన్లీ థర్డ్ ఎంప్లాయ్ రికార్డు మాత్రమే కావాలి నాకు అన్ని రికార్డ్స్ వద్దు అన్ని రికార్డ్స్ అంటే ఇప్పుడు ఒక ఆర్గనైజేషన్ లో కొన్ని వేల కోట్ల మంది ఉంటారు అందరి రికార్డ్స్ నేనేం చేసుకుంటాను ఆడిటోర్కి కావాలంటే అందరివి తీసిస్తాను కానీ అలా కాదు నాకు ఓన్లీ ఒక ఎంప్లాయ్ ఐడి 3 రికార్డు ఉన్నవాడివి మాత్రమే రికార్డు కావాలి అప్పుడు మనకి స్పెసిఫిక్ రికార్డు మనం తీసుకురావాలి కదా మ్యూల్ ద్వారా అంటే మనం ఎస్క్యూఎల్ డెవలపర్ లో ఏం చేస్తున్నాము ఈజీక్వల్స్ 3 అని డైరెక్ట్ గా పెడుతున్నాము సో దీనికి అర్థమైపోతుంది ఈజీక్వల్స్ 3 అన్నాం కాబట్టి మనకి 3 ఉన్నవి ఇక్కడ డిస్ప్లే చేసేస్తుంది కానీ మ్యూల్కి అలా చెప్తే అర్థం అవుద్దా అర్థం అవ్వదు కదా ఎందుకంటే ఇది ఎస్క్యూఎల్ డెవలపర్ కాదు ఇది మ్యూల్ దానికి అర్థమయ్యేటట్టు మనం చెప్పాలి ఇప్పుడు కోలన్ ఐడి అని పెట్టాను అనుకో అంటే నాకు పోస్ట్ మ్యాన్ నుంచి ఏదైతే వస్తుందో అదే తీసుకో అని చెప్పడం అనమాట ఓకే ఇప్పుడు ఈ ఐడిని మనం ఇక్కడ ఈ ఐడి యూస్ చేస్తాం సేమ్ ఇక్కడ ఏదైతే యూస్ చేస్తామో అదే ఐడి ఇక్కడ పెట్టుకోవాలి ఇది మారకూడదు ఈ కొటేషన్స్ లో ఇదే ఉండాలి ఈ వాల్యూలోకి ఫస్ట్ నువ్వు ఏంటి అట్రిబ్యూట్స్ ద్వారా నీ క్వెరీ పారామీటర్ లో నువ్వు పోస్ట్ మ్యాన్ నుంచి ఎంప్లాయీ ఐడి అన్న పేరుతో నువ్వు ఇస్తున్నావు ఆ వాల్యూని తీసుకొచ్చి ఇక్కడ అసైన్ చేసుకుంటున్నావు అప్పుడు ఇదేమైంది ఈ అట్రిబ్యూట్స్ ఈ మొత్తానికి ఇది ఇలా యూస్ చేయడం వల్ల దాని అర్థం ఏంటి అంటే నేను ఇక్కడ ఏదై ఈ ఎంప్లాయ్ ఐడిలో ఏ నంబర్ అయితే పంపిస్తానో ఆ నంబర్ ని తెచ్చి ఇక్కడ కూర్చోబెట్టింది అది 3 అయితే 3 5 అయితే 5 10 అయితే 10 ఏ నేను ఏ ఎంప్లాయ్ ఐడి ఇస్తే ఆ ఎంప్లాయ్ ఐడి ఇక్కడ అసైన్ అయింది ఈ ఐడి ఈ ఐడి సింక్ లో ఉంది కాబట్టి సేమ్ యూస్ చేసాం కాబట్టి అదే 2 అదే 5 ఇక్కడికి వెళ్తుంది వెళ్ళి ఎగ్జిక్యూట్ అవుతుంది క్లియర్ అందరికి అర్థమైంది అనుకుంటున్నాను ఎనీబడి ఈస్ హావింగ్ ఎనీ ఇష్యూస్ రైట్ ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మ్ మెసేజ్ ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మ్ తెలిసింది మన డేటాబేస్ ద్వారా మనం డైరెక్ట్ గా డైరెక్ట్ అవుత డేటాబేస్ అవుట్పుట్ ని పంపించలేము ఎందుకనంటే డేటాబేస్ ఎప్పుడు కూడా జావా అవుట్పుట్ ఇస్తుంది ఇట్ విల్ ఆల్వేస్ గివ్స్ జావా అవుట్పుట్ సో జావా ఈజ్ నాట్ ఎక్స్పెక్టెడ్ బై సోర్స్ సిస్టమ్ నాకు సోర్స్ వాడు ఏమంటాడు నాకు ఏం అర్థం కావట్లేదు మీరు ఇచ్చేది నాకు జేసన్ లో ఇవ్వండి అంటే మనం మార్చాలి కదా జేసన్ లో మనం బ్రోకర్స్ కదా వీఆర్ సిట్టింగ్ ఇన్ బిట్వీన్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద ఫార్మేట్ దే ఆర్ ఆస్కింగ్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అవర్ రెస్పాన్సిబిలిటీ టు కన్వర్ట్ ఇట్ అండ్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు సెండ్ సో ఇక్కడ నేను పేలోడ్ అనే పెడతాను ఎందుకు అంటే మీరు ట్రాన్స్ఫార్మ్ లాగి పెట్టంగానే పేలోడ్ లోపల ఈ 3 కాలమ్స్ ఉన్నాయి అంటే పేలోడ్ లోపలే కదా ఇవన్నీ ఉన్నాయి అంటే పేలోడ్ అని ఒకటి పెట్టుకుంటే చాలు కదా మనకి ఇక్కడ రైట్ చూడండి ఇక్కడ కనెక్షన్ ఎస్టాబ్లిష్ అయిపోయింది ఈ డేటా మొత్తం దీంట్లోకి మార్చేసాము మనం ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ లొకేషన్ దగ్గర బ్రేక్ పాయింట్ పెట్టుకుంటే మంచిది కాబట్టి బ్రేక్ పాయింట్ పెట్టాం ఆల్రెడీ మై సర్వర్ ఈజ్ రన్నింగ్ లెట్ అస్ సీ వెదర్ ఇట్ అప్డేట్స్ డైనమికలీ ఆర్ నాట్ సమ్ టైమ్స్ వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ ఈజ్ లైక్ ఐ సీ ఇఫ్ ఐఎమ్ మాడిఫైయింగ్ ఇన్ ద సేమ్ ఫ్లో వాట్ హ్యాపెన్స్ ఈజ్ ద జార్ విల్ గెట్ ఆటోమేటికలీ అప్డేటెడ్ సమ్ టైమ్స్ ఇట్ ఇరిటేట్స్ అస్ వీ హ్యావ్ క్రియేటెడ్ కంప్లీట్లీ అ న్యూ ఫ్లో ఇట్ మే అప్డేట్ ఇట్ మే నాట్ అప్డేట్ లెట్ అస్ వెరిఫై వెదర్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అప్డేటింగ్ ఆర్ నాట్ సో డిపెండ్స్ ఆన్ అవర్ సిస్టమ్స్ ఒక్కొక్కసారి అది అవ్వదు అప్పుడు మళ్ళీ వీ హ్యావ్ టు రీడిప్లాయ్ ద అప్లికేషన్ ఇన్ కేస్ ఇఫ్ యూ ఫీల్ లైక్ ఇట్ ఈస్ నాట్ అప్డేటింగ్ ద జార్ వీ హ్యావ్ టు రీడిప్లాయ్ ఇట్ సర్వర్ స్టాప్ చేసి స్టార్ట్ చేయాలి ఇట్ ఈస్ అప్డేటింగ్ ఫైన్ వీఆర్ గుడ్ ఈవెన్ దో ఐ హావ్ యాడెడ్ ఎ న్యూ ఫ్లో ఇన్ దట్ ప్రాజెక్ట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ అప్డేటింగ్ ద జార్ దెన్ ఇట్స్ కూల్ ఎస్ ఇట్ స్టార్టెడ్ ద అప్లికేషన్ దట్ మీన్స్ ఇట్ ఈస్ ఏబుల్ టు టేక్ దట్ రిక్వెస్ట్ స్టార్టెడ్ అప్లికేషన్ వచ్చింది Now I am hitting it. So I need a record of, now I require third employee details. I'll try to send it. It goes to that flow. Which is the record, it hold it. Why? Because I kept a breakpoint. Payload is null as it is not executed. And one more thing, in the attributes, try to observe. One query parameter is there. What query parameter I have used? ఈఎంపీ ఐడి అనేది ఒకటి యూజ్ చేశాను కదా నేను ఈఎంపీ ఐడి అనేది క్వశ్చన్ మార్క్ తర్వాత ఇచ్చాను కదా దట్ ఈస్ ద రీజన్ ఇన్ క్వరీ పారామీటర్ ఐ కుడ్ సీ దట్ వన్ రికార్డ్ ఈస్ కమింగ్ ఈఎంపీ ఐడి ఈజ్ ఈక్వల్స్ టు 3 సో వాట్ ఎవర్ ఐ హావ్ ఆఫ్టర్ క్వశ్చన్ మార్క్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ఐ హావ్ గివెన్ దట్ ఇట్ ఈస్ విల్ బి హోల్డెడ్ బై క్వరీ పారామ్స్ ఇన్ ద అట్రిబ్యూట్స్ దట్ ఈస్ ద ప్రాపర్టీ ఐ హావ్ యూజ్డ్ రైట్ దట్ ఈస్ వన్ చేంజ్ మెథడ్ ఈస్ గెట్ మెథడ్ గెట్ డేటా అనేది నేను సపరేటర్ యూజ్ చేస్తాను ఎవ్రీథింగ్ ఈస్ కమింగ్ సీ యూ కెన్ అబ్జర్వ్ ఇట్ Now I'm trying to next record 6 records. It came 3rd. Wait, which one I have executed, Baba? Okay, jar has not updated properly. This indicates jar has not updated. Jar update avaledu. See, 6 records it is coming. So that is false, na? If I am clicking on next, all the records it is coming. This indicates this is the bug in studio. Okay? Bug studio lo bug undi. Ante jar has not updated properly. In that case, nothing you have to do. No worries. No worries in our flow. Just stop your server. Try to run it in the debug mode once again. Sometimes it is a bug in any point studios. For some people it will feel, some people they may not feel. We have to observe carefully. Bear for 5 more minutes, please. I'll stop it. For Gopi, I think it is taking a lot of time. Otherwise, you can. I will just test it, Gopi. You can leave anyhow recording, I will share. Na?
Yeah. 5 minutes.
Okay. Yeah, only 5 minutes. Normally, I used to stop at 9:25 or 9:20 only. Today, I have started 5 minutes late. Na? So, even I will also try to start on sharp timings. Let it deploy. The jar has not, even though it showcased like it has updated, it has not updated properly. That made us again to deploy it. That is bug. See, now you can see. Hey, why 6 records it is coming? Anything, any problem in our query? That's too much. Everything we have given, attributes dot query params dot employee ID. There is a sync employee ID.
Instead of start.
No. Star means all columns we have to display, na? Total data of that record, na?
Okay.
Anyhow, it is time is up. Tomorrow we'll check on this. Okay. We'll try to stop here. Okay. If we start debugging again, it takes time. Tomorrow we'll debug. Okay.
Thank you,
ma'am.
Okay. Yes, Gopi, you can leave. It is too late for you.
Okay.
Others who can leave. Yeah. Aaj. Yes, please.
Madam, okay, debug dan gurinchi cheppara etla chustunnaru endiloki ellu chustunnaru.
Debug, the persons who can able, you want to leave, you can leave it. Okay. Navya is asking some questions on debug, so I'm explaining her. Okay. You can leave it. No problem. Navya, ఏంటి డీబగ్ గురించా? ఏం లేదు, డీబగ్ అంటే ఏంటి అంటే మనం ఈచ్ అండ్ ఎవ్రీ యాక్టివిటీ దగ్గర ఏం జరుగుతుందో చూడడానికి డీబగ్ పెట్టుకుందాం. ఓకే, ఇది పెట్టంగానే మనం ఇప్పుడు చూడండి, నేను ఇక్కడ నుంచి రిక్వెస్ట్ ఇచ్చినప్పుడు ఇది క్యాన్సిల్ చేస్తాను. ఇప్పుడు అబ్జర్వ్ చేయండి, ఇక్కడ నుంచి నేను రిక్వెస్ట్ ఇచ్చినప్పుడు ఆటోమేటిక్గా ఇవ్వండి, ఇక్కడ రెండు ఐకన్లు ఉంటాయి. ఓకే, డాటెడ్ ఐకన్ ఒకటి, డాట్ లేనిది ఒకటి. ఓకే, డాట్ లేని దాంట్లో ఉన్నామంటే ఇది నార్మల్ ఫ్లో, మనం ఏదైనా డెవలప్మెంట్ చేసేటప్పుడు ఇందులో చేస్తాం. డీబగ్ అంటే ఇక్కడ బ్లాక్ చుక్క ఉంది చూసారా, మ్యూల్ డీబగ్ అని ఉంది, దాన్ని ప్రెస్ చేయండి, అక్కడికి వెళ్ళిద్ది అది ఆటోమేటిక్గా.
నాకు క్లియర్గా లేదు మేడం, ఇది ఫుల్ స్క్రీన్ రా,
ఫుల్ స్క్రీన్ చూడండి.
ఇప్పుడు
ఓకే, ఇప్పుడు చూడండి, ఇక్కడికి వచ్చి ఆగిద్ది అనమాట. మీకు మళ్ళీ నేను అది క్లోజ్ చేసి ఇస్తాను. ఇవ్వండి, నేను ఇచ్చిన రిక్వెస్ట్కి ఇక్కడికి వచ్చి ఆగింది. మీరు ఏం చేయాలంటే ఇక్కడ నెక్స్ట్, ఇక్కడ నెక్స్ట్ ప్రాసెసర్ ఉంది కదా, దాన్ని నొక్కండి, నెక్స్ట్ యాక్టివిటీకి వెళ్ళిద్ది అది.
ఎక్కడ నొక్కారు మేడం ప్రాసెసర్?
ఇక్కడ రైట్ సైడ్.
ఓకే ఓకే,
ఇక్కడ ఇక చూడండి, ఇక ఇది నెక్స్ట్ ప్రాసెసర్ ఉందా, దాన్ని
ఓకే
ప్రెస్ చేస్తే అది నెక్స్ట్ ఐకాన్కి వెళ్ళింది, తర్వాత
ఓకే
మళ్ళీ ఇంకొకసారి ప్రెస్ చేస్తే ఫ్లో ఎండ్ అయిపోయింది, అప్పుడు మీకు ఇక్కడ అవుట్పుట్ వచ్చింది. అర్థమైందా?
మేడం దీనికి ఎస్క్యూఎల్ పక్కా రావాలా లేకపోతే ఏంటి?
ఏ లేదు లేదు, అవసరం లేదమ్మా. ఏంటి అంటే జస్ట్ మనకి సిస్టమ్స్, టార్గెట్ సిస్టమ్, సర్వర్ సిస్టమ్ ఎవరు ఉండరు కదా, అన్ని మనమే చేసుకోవాలి కదా.
ఓకే ఓకే
ఓకే, ఇప్పుడు అందుకని కావాల్సినంత నేను చెప్తాను.
ఆహా, మీరు ఇక్కడ ఇది ఆల్రెడీ టైప్ చేసి పెట్టుకున్నారా లేకపోతే మీరు క్రియేట్ చేసిందా మేడం ఇది?
నేను క్రియేట్ చేశాను. నేను మీరు లాస్ట్ క్లాస్ మీరు అటెండ్ అవ్వలేదు అందుకని మీకు అర్థం అవ్వట్లేదు. ఫస్ట్ అవి వినండి, అట్లీస్ట్ అవి వినండి, ఒకసారి చూడండి, అప్పుడు అర్థం అవుతుంది. ప్రతి స్టెప్ నేను చేశాను, ఇన్స్టాలేషన్ ఆఫ్ డేటాబేస్ కానించి చేశా.
ఓకే ఓకే,
ఒక్కసారి రేపు క్లాస్కి వచ్చే ముందు అవన్నీ చూసుకొని రండి, అప్పుడు మీకు అర్థం అవుతుంది.
ఓకే మేడం,
ఓకే. ఇంకా డౌట్స్ ఉంటే మళ్ళీ రేపు డిస్కస్ చేద్దాం. ఓకే, చలో, ఓకే, బాయ్. ఇంకెవరికైనా ఇంకా మిగతా వాళ్ళకి ఏం డౌట్స్ లేవు కదా? సంతోష్ కృష్ణ, ఎవ్రీవన్ ఇస్ కూల్ రైట్? యా, ఓకే, బాయ్.